Welcome to another video. I am shooting outside today and there may be a little bit of residual noise here and there, but I just really wanted to be outside today. I woke up and I decided I needed to make a grid. I feel like I need to make a grid for creative energy because it's just something that I feel like I need to boost in myself right now. I've been in a place of introspection and kind of trying to zoom out and look at the big picture of life and just try to reimagine what life is going to look like. So I'm just ready to be a little bit more creative. I want to feel excited to get up and paint every day or to wire wrap a really beautiful stone that I've been meaning to do. I just have all these things I've been meaning to do, but I'm not actually doing any of them. So I want to make this creative energy grid and I wanted to make it outside because it just feels great out here, even though it's so loud. Oh my God, it's so loud. And I also just, I feel really creative in this space. This is my little outside hut area that I'm in all the time. I've been painting the ceiling over the past couple of weeks and it is not even close to being finished, but it just feels really, really good out here. There's like a sneak peek of the beginnings of my ceiling. So, let me show you the stones I brought out here. So I just decided to grab this tray and put all the crystals that I thought would be helpful for this grid to put on here and bring out, and then I'll just start playing with them and putting them around. What I'm focusing on is our lower three chakras. So your root chakra, which is symbolized by reds, so I have a couple different types of jasper here for that. And then your sacral chakra is represented by orange, so I brought a lot of orange stones out here. And then your solar plexus chakra is represented by yellow. So that's the whole feeling I'm going with this grid, activating those lower three chakras. Already when I think of creativity, I think about oranges and yellows, and it's supposed to give you that kind of like creative boost, but yellow to me also brings energy. So it's like bringing energy to the creativity. And I think it's really important to include the root chakra in this because it's almost like you don't want to just be blocked in one area of your body. You want it to be able to flow from somewhere. That's kind of just the feeling I got, that I want it to be able to flow through all three chakras and not just be like stuck in one spot. I think that a lot of people actually look right to the root chakra when they are having creativity blocks. So all in all, I feel like creating a grid with all of these colors and this kind of like warm energy is really going to be helpful for what I'm trying to do. So this is how I laid them out for myself when I was going around picking them up, because so I picked up a couple of these natural citrines and I was like, okay, so yellow. So I want to have four yellow stones. So I got out this golden appetite, and then this is a heat treated piece of citrine. But so that's why I have all four of them right here like this, so that I can see that I will be able to create symmetry with this. I don't know what this is going to look like yet, but I set myself up so that I have symmetrical units that even if they're not exactly the same color like some of these, they at least have the same sort of energy to me. Same size, same shape, same general color scheme area. I'm going to end up leaving the grid up overnight, I think, maybe. And I'll go through what all of these are with you while we're actually making the grid. All right, I decided for the center of this grid, I wanted to put this piece of orange calcite. Both because I have really been feeling orange calcite lately, but also because it fits right into what I want out of this grid. you know, a big orange piece in the middle of a creativity grid. I can't think of a much more appropriate thing than that. And I also love that this is almost like a natural flame shape. So I'm going to sit it so that the flame points upwards. So I know you can't tell looking down on it, but this is the point that actually comes up. So I'm going to put that in the middle somewhere. I don't know. I guess we should do it right in the middle of this kind of flower. And I don't have any idea where I'm gonna go next with this. I feel like I wanna put these selenites on both sides of this. And we're just gonna start building. And selenite is great to put in a grid because it will keep the whole thing charged and cleansed. But also just when I go around intuitively picking up crystals for a grid, these jumped out at me. As soon as I picked this up, I looked at these and I knew I had to pick them up as well. So we'll put those right there. And I'm just going to start playing. I think I'll put these natural citrines across from each other and these across from each other. This is a Shiva Lingam. Well, it's not in the shape of a Shiva Lingam. It's a Shiva Lingam tumbled stone. And this is actually one of my favorite stones for root chakra work. I have a larger Shiva Lingam inside that I love, 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 love. These are black chalcedonies. And they're just very unique in that they are completely a black circle. A lot of them come with little like white jersey on them. I really like the all black ones. They're very good for connecting with nature. Right now I'm just trying to create a little bit of symmetry, and I'm still not sure what's gonna happen. I might end up moving all of this. We just have to wait and see. So I feel like I actually want these like all the way out here. So I'm gonna start moving them out. I just wanna build in here a little bit more. And I feel like I want to put, this is a smoky quartz point and this is a citrine point, a smoky citrine point. So I feel like these would be perfect going opposite each other. And then just because these are both kind of the same size-ish, and they both have a lot of lines on them, even though these lines go this way and these lines go this way, I find them to be similar in that manner. These are third eye agates. They're made out of sardonyx. I feel like sardonyx is really good for the root chakra. There's just something about these I love. So see how like it's not cute sometimes at first, but then you put things in, you adjust a little bit, and then you make it into the art. I definitely want to incorporate some amber. I have this piece of amber that is just such a cool shape. And then I'm going to use this small piece of amber as well. So I thought to balance it out, I would put a couple of pieces of pyrite on the side with the small amber. I'm gonna put this up here. Move this up a little. Okay. This just started to feel like something. I can feel energy coming out of this now. Before this point, I couldn't feel anything. Maybe it's because this is pointing at me. Definitely want to use this. This is another one I looked at and I picked it up immediately. I knew it was supposed to be in here. This stone is a piece of crop circle flint. And I talk about these in my UK crystal haul. I will link that for you guys. It's a very, very cool feeling stone, and I just felt like it fit right into this grid because of the color, but also because it just felt very earthy to me. So I want to use this a lot. And so I want to find something that will balance the energy of this on the other side. And I'm thinking
I'm just immediately drawn to use this yellow jasper on the other side of this for some reason. Okay, I feel like I want to move these out even more and do something like this is a big third eye agate piece of sardonyx. Maybe put it in there like that. This is a little ring that was holding this sphere. It rolled right off. Do I like that? I don't know. So I feel like to balance that out, this would be a cool crystal. It's the same size-ish. Look at this. See how different they are, but how similar they are in size and in that they both have a point going both ways this way. And it's just, I feel like this is a perfectly balanced thing to put in a grid, even though they're completely different crystals and completely different energies.
Maybe they put it that way. Maybe that more. And then let's get it here. And I just want to put some clear quartz points out here so I can feel this a little bit more, so it starts feeling a little more finished. And these are just four similar-ish clear quartz points. Let's try this. See how sometimes things can just take a turn immediately and everything looks different and better? That's what just happened here. Now this has more of a feeling of like a sun, and that makes me so happy. Like, I'm sitting here and I'm like, I think it's done. Do I want to add anything else? And then like something flies by and catches my attention and I'm like, just lost in a daydream for a little bit, and I look down at the grid and I have zero desire to do anything to it. This grid is finished. This is what it's supposed to be. And you know, you don't have to use all the crystals you thought you were going to use. Sometimes it's just done when it's done. So I'm going to move all these out of the way, and this is the finished grid. I'm sorry if it's a little hard to see on this carpet. I just really wanted to be outside with it today, you guys. It feels so nice. That is it for me today, you guys. Thank you so much for watching.